Hello there and welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how I have created a Flask web application. And the specialty of this web application is that it can render markdown into HTML. And it uses the Flask and the markdown modules. And technically, the idea was to imbue this web application in a sense that you can create your own subpages and upload newer markdown files to the subpages, and these are dynamically picked up on the index page. So let's get to it. First, I'm going to download it. You can reach it on GitHub. I will link the source in the description. Now we enter the web app directory and create a virtual env MD web app, and I have attached requirements.txt into this stuff, so you can easily, let's say, reproduce the environment in which this app is running. And the page creation and the upload pages are protected with username and password. So that part is not yet really polished, but it's working. And after the MD web app completes the virtual environment, we are going to look into the, let's say, source files. Until then, what I'm going to do is open this folder and start to walk you through. So here we have the requirements.txt, and basically this is just the Flask and the markdown module and its dependent modules. I have this readme file, which is kind of the welcome page on the GitHub repository. This just tells you how you can use this application. And this is where the fun begins. So let's call the MD web app scripts activate and pip install -r requirements. And how does this whole application work? So we have a static folder which holds the CSS and the fav icon, and we have the MD folder, which is kind of the structure of your web page. So in the MD folder, when you hit the default context root, what it will try to do is to render the index markdown file. And this is hard-coded in the script. So it will look for the application root path for an index.md. And if you have this index.md, it is going to open it, read it, and render it. And there are two extensions which I'm using. The first one is the fence code, and the other is the code highlight. This allows you to add code snippets in your markdown file, and when you render it in an HTML site, you will have nice coloring and fancy look. If not, then it is going to set the MD content to none, and it will render a little bit differently. So we have our dependencies. So let's see how this application runs. We are going to go to the localhost, and the 8000 Why is it not loading? Let's try it again. Okay. And the 8080. Very good. So let me enlarge this one. So this is the default index.markdown file. And this is just, let's say, little reference that I have put in. And Let me just remove that white space and reload the page. So now you can use the URL for my YouTube channel. You can see that I'm an instructor on Udemy and Skillshare, and I am working also as a plural site author. So the gears behind this are mentioned here. It shows a little bit of demonstration as to what you can do. This is the code highlighting and the fenced code. You can also embed URLs for YouTube videos. You can also, have a go at the getting started with this application. So let's go to the folder manager. Here you can see that it is asking for a username and password. So call it admin and start 123 exclamation mark. And it's not. Oh yeah. Now let's try it again. Let's go to the folder manager. Admin start exclamation mark 123. And it's not working because it is user. So start exclamation mark 123. And as you can see, you can manage folders. You could create a whenever manage wherever folders. You will see the results of the last action. And if you go back here, you can see that these folders were created. So let's try and create a markdown file, which we will upload here. So let's call it test.md. Save it in the webapp root. And welcome to my channel. Python is fun, and let's show some code highlight. So when you are using code highlight or fence code, you should mark the type of the language for which this code block belongs to, so it will be able to render properly. For I in range 10, print this is fun and I, and let's make it an F string, and the reference and https google.com. Okay, we have saved it. Now what we need to do is to go back to the default site and inspect the page manager. So we need to choose where we would like to upload this, which folder, and if I say whenever, I choose the file. So this is on my desktop, mdwebapp.test.md, and we would like to overwrite the file if it exists. As you can see, it successfully saved the test.md to whenever folder. Let's see. And it did. So now, if you go back to the index page, you can see that there is a list of routes which is dynamically built. So if I open the whenever root, you can see that it rendered the markdown file properly. And there is an addition here, so it will say the name of the file and when it was created. And if you append multiple files or upload multiple files, this will separate them. And this is kind of practical, so to speak. So I'm not sure if I should go really deep into the Python code, but as for the, let's say, templates, I'm going to talk a little bit more about it. So I have a base.html, and if you're familiar with Jinja, you know that this allows you to let's say, reuse or fine-tune your HTML files. And I have defined a block content, and on the index page, what I'm doing is I say this page extends the base.html, so it will inherit everything that is defined in the base.html, and I say that my block content should contain this. And in the webapp.py, you can see that if there is a marked index.md, it is going to read the content and pass it to the template. And what happens here is that if it's going to check to see if that content is not none, because if it's none, there is nothing to render. And if it can render anything, it should be pushed with the safe pipe. So it marks the, let's say, content as safe. It's a security feature of the Werkzeug network framework. So after that, we are also checking how many routes we have. And for every route, there is a reference in the index page. And this is also dynamically updated as you upload new pages or create new folders. And I have this folderer, which is responsible for uploading and or for creating and deleting folders. I have the upload form, which is for uploading the markdown files. And this is the code which renders the contents of the markdown files of the specific context routes. And this is defined in a symbol function. And technically that's it. Let me know what you think of this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Thank you for watching.